I had a really strange experience with Roland Emmerich's 1998 reimagining of Godzilla. When I first saw the movie, I wasn't particularly impressed by it. I thought it was just a kind of a giant iguana film, and for the most part, I didn't really like it that much. The script wasn't so hot, the acting wasn't so great, the action sequences were fine, but some of them really kind of felt like they were ripped directly out of Jurassic Park. Overall, I was very underwhelmed by the movie. In the 11 years since it came out, I've never gone back to rewatch it because I really never felt a need to. Then the Blu-ray comes along, and I have to review it, and I thought, well, this could be fun to kind of go back and see if there's anything about it that I missed the first time. And as I'm watching it, I'm realizing, okay, the script still isn't that great. The acting still isn't that great. I think several characters were miscast. And even worse, now the special effects that seemed so cutting edge back in 1998, because of the Blu-ray transfer, they really don't look as good. They don't hold up nearly as well. The creature effect still works fine. Godzilla is still animated just fine. But it's his interactions with the environment around him that the high-definition transfer really shows off, that they're not in the same physical space. What's weird is that despite all of those negatives going into it, I had a hell of a good time watching this movie. I have no idea why. It has so many flaws, I can't even begin to count them, but none of them seem to matter this time around. I watched the movie, I really enjoyed it, I got into all of the action, I got into all of the action, the science fiction sequences, really enjoyed watching this monster tear up New York City, I really enjoyed watching the characters on the run, from baby Godzillas, and I almost called them Velociraptors because of the fact that they look just like Velociraptors from Jurassic Park. Something about the film really worked for me this time. I couldn't put my finger on what it was to save my life, but I really enjoyed it. It's a fun, fun movie. I think maybe people like myself judged it too harshly the first time around because maybe we had expectations that were higher than what they should have been. But I think this is a movie that's really worth a second viewing. Maybe you'll still won't like it if you didn't like it the first time around, but boy, I'll tell you, I had a lot of fun watching it. Technically speaking, this is a good Blu-ray presentation in that it really captures the film it's supposed to capture. What that does, though, like I said earlier, is it shows off all the technical deficiencies. The special effects really, really don't work as well in high definition because you can just see all the flaws. You can see all the stuff that's green screened. You can see where the CGI is not interacting with the physical environment the way it's supposed to. And it really doesn't do the film any favors. Somehow I was able to get past that, but be aware that by watching it on Blu-ray, you're actually kind of highlighting the flaws rather than hiding them. The surround sound is fantastic, though. It's an action-packed film. You get the sights and sounds of New York City brought to life all around you in 360 degrees. So your speakers will definitely get a workout from this track. In terms of extra features, you get, I believe, the same things that were on the original DVD. There's a visual effects commentary, a behind-the-scenes featurette, an all-time best of fight scenes, which I thought would be really cool. It's actually kind of an extended commercial for other Godzilla movies. A Heroes music video by the Wallflowers, and then you do get a couple of Blu-ray exclusives. None of them too exciting. You get the Movie IQ feature, which basically lets you get current, consistently updated trivia on actors, locations, things like that. It's kind of a live IMDb.com feature. And there's a Godzilla multiplayer trivia game, which was admittedly more challenging than I expected it to be, even though I played it right after watching the film. Like I said, Godzilla is not a perfect movie. It has a lot of flaws. It doesn't have great casting. The characters aren't great. The script isn't great. And Lord knows, even in high definition, the special effects aren't great. So why did I enjoy it so much this time around? I have absolutely no idea. But I can tell you that I do give it my recommended stamp, believe it or not.